My name is Melissa Wenzel, and I'm an inspector with the Minnesota Pollution Control Agency's Industrial Stormwater Program. As you know, the Industrial Stormwater Multi-Sector General Permit requires all permittees to conduct benchmark monitoring. Today, I'll be demonstrating how to collect a stormwater sample using the sheet flow sampling method. The process for collecting and submitting results can be broken down into six parts. I will be demonstrating part four, how to collect a stormwater sample using the sheet flow sampling method. At the end of this video, we'll provide links to the other parts of the stormwater sampling process. A sheet flow sample is a sample that's flowing over an impervious or gravel surface. While there might be other ways to collect this sample, I will demonstrate one that is low in cost, easy to collect, and should be appropriate for most facilities. Be sure to have these materials ready ahead of time, right before you're going to collect your sample. What you need to be able to collect a sample for sheet flow sampling is 3 2-gallon Ziploc bags, 1 1-quart size Ziploc bag, 1 pair of gloves, an item like a shovel handle or other device to create a dam, a small quantity of wet or dry sand, scissors, sampling jars, a cooler, and ice. Be sure to choose a time and location where stormwater is flowing, and collect the sample within the first 30 minutes of a measurable runoff event. Before you go outside, write the name of the person collecting the sample and the date. Cut the top and sides off one of the 2-gallon bags. Unfold that bag. Fill the other 2-gallon bags about a quarter full of sand. Squeeze all of the air out of the bags and zip the bags shut. Cut the top off the quart size bag. Now, let's go outside to collect the sample. Find a flat, smooth area that is representative of the sheet flow runoff from your industrial stormwater discharges and lay the plastic sheet down on the ground in the direction of stormwater flow. Place the sandbags on the sampling surface so that it creates a funneling effect for the sheet flow. Place the shovel handle under the plastic, which will help you to collect your sample. Place your fingers inside the bag to open the bag's mouth. Place it over the shovel handle or other device to allow the stormwater to flow inside the plastic bag. Lift the top of the bag to transfer the sample to the bottom of the bag. Continue until you have enough stormwater in the plastic bag. Shake the plastic bag and pour the sample into your sample jar. You'll notice that I'm not placing my fingers or hands over the top or inside the bottle when collecting the sample. Otherwise, I might contaminate the sample. Your lab should have instructed you how full the bottle should be. Fill it to the level they instructed you to fill it. If the sample bottles came with preservatives, add them now. Be careful not to spill, as preservatives are most often acids. Cap the sample bottle. Then, record the time the sample was collected. Place the samples inside a resealable plastic bag and place the bottles into the cooler. Prepare the cooler according to lab instructions for pickup or shipment to the lab. Often, labs require that the samples be packed in ice to help preserve the sample. After you've taken your sample, make sure to take thorough notes on how the sampling event went and facility conditions. You might want to consider taking a photo of sampling conditions after you take your sample. This might help remind you of site conditions when filling out the monitoring report. That's it. While I demonstrated how to collect a sheet flow sample, you might be collecting from another location, such as a manhole, ditch, or swale. Be sure to check out our grab sample video if that's the case. For more information about the best sampling methods, tips to sampling the right way, visit the program's website at www.pca.state.mn.us/industrial-stormwater. Go to the What's New section to find the sampling manual, It is filled with more detailed information about all parts of the stormwater sampling process.